Get your free copy of the complete tutorial at www.teachucomp.com/free.
After creating a company file, you should customize its settings. To access these settings, click the Gear button. Then click the Account and Settings link under the Your Company section of the drop-down menu to open an Account and Settings window. The six different categories of company settings appear in the menu at the left side of the screen. They are Company, Billing and Subscription, Sales, Expenses, Payments, and Advanced. The Company settings appear when the window opens. However, you can click any of the settings in this menu to display the individual settings in that category at the right side of the window. The Company Settings category contains the company name, company type, contact info, address, and communications with Intuit sections. There is a pencil icon at the right side of each section, with the exception of the communications with Intuit section, that you can click to edit the settings in each section. In the Company Name section, you can edit the company name, add a company logo, enter a legal name, and enter your employer ID or EIN. To add a company logo, click the plus sign next to the company logo. A file upload dialog box then appears. Use it to navigate to your logo and then click it to select it. Then click the open button to upload your logo. At this time, you cannot delete a logo. The company name field lets you edit your company name. If the legal name is the same as the company name, leave the Same as Company Name checkbox checked. Otherwise, uncheck the checkbox and enter your company's legal name into the field that then appears. Enter your employer identification number into the Employer ID or EIN field. When finished, click the Save button to save the information that you entered. The Company Type section lets you edit the tax form and industry selected for your company. You can use the Tax Form drop-down to select the type of tax form filed by the company. You can start typing an industry into the industry field to show matching choices in the drop-down menu that appears. You can then click the choice that you want. When finished, click the Save button to save your changes. The Contact Info section lets you edit the contact information for the company. Enter the email address at which QuickBooks can contact you into the Company Email field. Enter a customer-facing email, which is used by customers and shown on invoices, into the customer-facing email field. If the customer-facing email is the same as the company email, then leave this field blank and check the Same as Company Email checkbox instead. Enter the phone number to print on invoices into the company phone field. Finally, enter the website address shown on sales forms into the website field. When finished, click the Save button to save your settings. In the Address section, enter the company address into the fields and drop-down shown. If you have a different customer-facing address or legal address, uncheck the Same as Company Address checkbox for the appropriate section, and then enter the alternate address into the fields that appear. When finished, click the Save button to save your changes. In the Communications with Intuit section, click the Marketing Preferences link to open a separate web page. In this web page, check or uncheck the checkboxes to decide how Intuit may contact you. Then click the Next button to enter or verify your contact information. Click the Next button again to review your preferences, and then click the Submit button to submit your marketing preferences. You can then close the web page when you are finished. To close the Account and Settings window, click the Done button in the lower right corner or click the X button in the upper right corner.
Like what you see? Pick up your free copy of the complete tutorial at www.teachucomp.com/free.